my goodness.
Wow.
I'm going to need that monkey lizard.
Absolutely.
Oh, my gosh.
Here to tell us a little bit more about all of the wonderful things she just saw is our very good friend, Ashley Eckstein.
You guys, I have an Ahsoka doll.
That was incredible.
The Toydarian toy maker.
Yes.
You know, I love it.
And I'm not one to like really get geeky about merch, but all of those creatures, and it's just so cool.
It was literally like my dream come true in there. I'm going to move to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge.
Yes.
You guys can be neighbors.
We've been trying to get the immigration process started. There's a lot of paperwork, but I'm going to do it.
Me too. Okay, we're neighbors.
So you've actually been to Galaxy's Edge.
I have been to Galaxy's Edge.
Can you tell us anything?
Ahsoka Tano gets to go where she wants.
Like everything.
You know what? I have to tell you, there were tears. I thought I would be sobbing the whole time, but in fact, I just giggled like a five-year-old little girl. I was just like, like the whole time. And it's true, all of it, like they say, and it far exceeded any expectation I ever had. I felt, I still don't even believe it's real.
Did you get yourself any of that Minock jerky?
Do I need it?
I saw Minock jerky and I was like, that's where I'm going.
Well, no, I have to tell you, first of all, the rides are just mind blowing. And then the merchandise and then the food and the whole land and the experience, it just keeps getting better and better and better.
Well, and you're somebody who works with parks very closely. You have merchandise in the parks, you're designing things for the parks. So you're used to the level of things.
You're a bit of a Disney fanatic.
Yeah.
Yes. I'm a Disney nut. And that is, I proudly say I'm a Disney nut in a great way. But this, again, Disney just raised the bar so high. Mm-hmm. My mind was blown, literally blown into a million pieces. I can't even find my words. That's how amazing it is.
That's super cool.
And it's not even open yet. So you haven't even felt the real story or the immersiveness of it all.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's only going to get better, like you said.
No, it was still under construction.
Right.
So I did have a hard hat on and a vest and glasses. But you know,
was it an in-universe hard hat?
It was an in-universe hard hat, yes. No, but Scott Trowbridge actually gave me a tour and just painted the whole picture for me. And I have to tell you guys, it's everything you've ever wanted and more. Yeah. It's everything you've ever wanted and more! Ooh. Yes! It's so good!
And I think the real magic is going to be when it's full of people like us, full of Star Wars fans, just, you know, living the dream and having fun every
day. Because that's the thing that we were talking about as we were watching the panel, and I'm sure you all are doing the same thing, where it's like, this is amazing, but what's going to really make it amazing is, like, we have always wanted to be in one of these crowded marketplaces, right? We have always wanted to be in one of these, like, alien marketplaces together. And it's going to be amazing when everybody's just, like, up in these stalls together, like, looking at things, sitting down in the cantina together. It's going to change everything.
I imagine it'll feel a lot like this.
Yeah.
It really is. It's such an immersive experience, unlike anything I've ever experienced in my entire life.
So cool. So you actually brought a few surprises for us right now.
So I have one more surprise.
She took it. They didn't know. She put it under her shirt and she ran.
This one, they're keeping a surprise even from me. But, you know, they showed me the doll, and my good friend Brad Schoenberg, who we just saw in the video, the director of merchandise for Star Wars, has another exclusive reveal. Do you guys want to see it?
Oh. Yeah.
Yes! All right. Brad, come on out.
Yeah.
Yes, Brad Schoenberg!
No! No!
Uh-oh.
No!
Is that...
What is that? We know this symbol.
I see the symbol.
I see
I don't know if
you guys can
see symbol. That.
There is a fulcrum symbol on a box. What is this, Brad?
Been waiting to show these to you and to everyone else for the very first time.
Shut
up.
Right there. Point it right there.
Look at...
Oh, my gosh.
That is so beautiful.
Those are amazing! No.
Here.
Yeah,
here,
yeah.
Here, take them both. Oh. Assume the rightful place.
Yes!
wait, can we?
Yes. Yes. He asked if we wanted to power them up. Obviously, yes.
Yeah, of course.
Oh my God. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Oh, wow.
Okay, where's the Saber Guild when I need them?
I'm sure there's a few out there.
Yes.
Yo!
Yes!
Oh my gosh! Woo! Unbelievable. So,
you got it. Oh.
Yep, that's it.
Woo!
Oh!
Woo! Wow. Yeah.
We need to get out of the way.
Oh. You be careful. You're deadly with those.
These are incredible. So, okay. Brad, where can we get these?
These are going to be at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at Doc Ondar's Den of Antiquities. Doc's gotten his hands on just a few key legacy lightsabers that have been around the galaxy, and somehow he got his hands on these two. And these will actually be our first white-bladed high-end lightsabers that we're selling. So.
Yeah!
Yes. Oh, my gosh. So when these are sold out, you guys know who bought them all. Yeah. Me, I apologize.
It was me.
So Brad, let's talk about some of the features of these and some of the things that are unique about these as opposed to lightsabers we might have seen in the past.
What's great about these is you saw the way I brought them out. Each lightsaber from a legacy perspective is created. Each has an icon on it that gives you a hint to the character that would be inside of it. So you see Ahsoka's here. We made the blades all detachable because we know everybody's going to want to wear them as you go around Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. If you take a visit to our booth today, you can see the robes, tunics, really everything you need to get into character. And the belts are made to carry these lightsabers, including Ahsoka's double sabers.
Oh my gosh.
These Ashley, how does this feel?
Again, I'm having a hard time finding my words because this day is so surreal, you know, between the doll and the lightsabers. And I have to say, I've been a longtime friend of Brad and his whole team. And let me tell you what, they are Star Wars fans. And if you guys even knew the amount of detail that they went into to making all of this merchandise, I'm so proud. Congratulations on the amazing work. You guys are going to love it.
Thank you so much for coming by. We have lots more from Star Wars Celebration Chicago right here on the Star Wars Show Live, presented by GEICO. Don't go anywhere. Woo!